Hey everybody, Stobbie here. Back again with some more XCOM 2. It's Operation Crimson Tome. Running a raid and advent troop transport. It's gonna be difficult, and I have no reason to suspect it won't be very difficult. Luckily though, we've got a full load, a full 8 squad members. Loads of magnetic weapons as well. Shotgun. That's just ballistic. Boltcaster, of course. That's magnetic. Sharpshooter is still using ballistic, but our shinobi is using mag weapons as well. And seeing that we have an upgrade here, weapon upgrade, what is that? An advanced repeater. Yeah, we're going to sell that. I don't use repeaters because repeaters are bullshit. Yes, the long shot Mark II has the improved scope, so our sniper is going to have wonderful aim. Really glad we got this troop transport raid. We need the resources so badly. We're making the rush through to the proving ground to get that skulljack. To make sure that we don't lose the campaign. What worries me is building the proving ground is going to take like 24 days.
In position for deployment.
So we're going to have to rush construction. And the skulljack takes, I think, a week to research, so I don't know. We'll see.
To disable in this area, and the aliens have apparently struggled to get it moving again. This is our chance to strike. Anything we can recover from that transport will be a boost to our efforts. Move in and secure the surrounding area. Eliminate all hostile contacts with extreme prejudice.
The other option is to go for a comms uplink and try to grab West Africa. The problem with that is it'll take 20 odd days to build the comms link, even if we start it right now. We still then have to make contact with West Africa. Which we obviously can't do until we build the comms link. That'll be 21 days plus 8 days, so 29. Ready at 27.
The troop transport is nearby. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
Interesting, so we've got a structure to fight out of here. I'd like to do that if we can. Being nice, high cover here, 1, 2, 3, is there a second floor here, beautiful, 4, 5, and then a rooftop there for our sniper. Okay, it's pretty obvious what we got to do here. The structure, I mean, it's going to be right on top of these aliens, but with 8 soldiers we have pretty good DPS, so I'm pretty confident we can do it. Besides, we can always get ourselves into cover and then just hold up and wait for the patrols to move around into a setup or situation where we're ready to engage. The Aussie lass, not get on the roof, mate.
Already there.
Ooh, is that a yellow move? Ah, bollocks. Just gotta bear in mind that the increased detection radius. Ooh, is it no longer effective? Good. If it was effective, we would still see the red little down arrows there saying increased detection radius. That's okay. Good. I think we will put Chris Ed, who's our ranger, right there. Put Jack, who's our specialist, there. Grenadier there. Someone else who wants to direct fire over there. Then we'll have our shinobi. You know what? Let's start sneaking. Our shinobi on the left flank. We want to be able to see where the enemies are and then just pop open this door once we're ready to fight them. Who else is going to be on the roof? Just our sniper, Captain Wardy. Or is that not going to
move up on the double?
That won't pop stealth, so I'm happy to have him run there. Okay, so these two are going to be on the roof, and these five I think are going to take these spots here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Sniper all the way over there. Do we though? You know what, if I'm clever I can maybe put the sniper over here. Then when everyone comes to engage this way we have flanking shots, but dangerous. Actually, I'm not sure where to put the sniper Reno. Does he have damn good ground? He does not. Might even be worth it just putting him just somewhere really out of the way. My concern is with putting him here that there might be pods over there. And our sniper will have a bad time. Maybe just up here. That's definitely a spot someone has to take. High ground, height advantage. Wait, why don't we put our ranger there? So he'll have a commanding view of the battlefield. And he'll be height advantage shooting. Yes. Huge stats. I like that.
All right.
Ooh, why is there a door there? Oh yes, because you can actually get to that cover there. But I think we'll put the governator on that spot.
The Iceman cometh.
I'm not getting tired of that. That's awesome. Let's see. So Ben Barton with Boltcaster. There's Jawara.
Yes, sir.
Our grenadiers and our specialists on the ground floor.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Standard shotgun. I could have sworn. Oh yeah. We had some modified shotguns, but they got lost two missions back. Shit happens. Ooh, that's a battle scanner. Our sniper. So let's go ahead and use it. Worst thing that can happen now is if we get surprised, there's something on this roof. Unlikely, but I think it's definitely worth spending a battle scanner just to make sure that we don't get a surprise when we take the roof now. Wait. How's he last get up there?
On my way.
We'll actually spend the next battle scanner to scan the front of this building or have Campana sneak there. Because the other concern is you spend a few turns getting these guys up here. As soon as you put Chris there, he'll be revealed by whatever's in there. That no. Similarly, running the governor up there now is quite dangerous. But putting him at this bit of high cover is fine just for the moment. Governor will take that position eventually, but going to there straight away now, if there's anything in here, he will get revealed. As always, this is just the setup phase. I apologize for making boring, but this is where I think half the battle is won. Getting this right is just so important.
Copy that.
Holding my breath there. As I told him to move, I realized how a risky move that was.
I'm all over it.
I don't expect that James Jawara is going to be shooting from this position. I just want him to be there and be ready to jump down, take one of these positions. Oh, hang on, has he got? Oh yes, he actually got aggression as his advanced warfare perk. Interesting. If that applies to his grenades, it'll be just ridiculously overpowered. I don't think it will though. Hopefully nothing on the left flank here. Hopefully.
Yeah, very sensitive.
Yeah, very sensitive. I think we want Wardy over here, our sharpshooter over here. Further back.
At your convenience, of course.
You wait, buddy. I hear a mech stomping about. And some chrysalids. Honor. I'm gonna select a predator. There you go, buddy. Good, so there's nothing here at the moment. Almost ready to take the edge of that roof there. See, that's still unrevealed, so it's still too dangerous to come here now. But to be fair, we do need another turn or two to get our sniper into position.
Formation's too tight, loosen up!
Sniper needs to be there. Move one more way. Got it. Chris can go there whenever he needs to. James can go there when he needs to. Ozzy less, so she can stay.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Well, this is boring.
Arnie, that's still too risky.
Scanning. Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Quite tense. This is a difficult mission, so there's going to be a lot of aliens we're dealing with. Also need to bear in mind the fact that Chris is on the roof there. Oh, scary. I think this is exactly what I was concerned about. Camera, excuse me. Would that be a reveal? No, it would not. Okay. So what do we have here? 13 hit points, advanced warden. Wow. Just want to get our sniper into position where he can take steady weapon, and then we'll open up with a precision shot for a big crit. Make sure we don't have too much on this right flank here. There could still be stuff right here though. That's too dangerous. On the next turn, maybe. Careful. Remember, that's a ballistic weapon. Come on, that should be high cover, for goodness sake. That kind of ruins everything. Let's put... That'll do, pig. Okay. But to check that...
It's a good idea.
Yes, it is a good idea. What you can actually do, you can open up with the suppression, which holo-targets all of them, and then as the one that you've suppressed moves, you then get Overwatch, and you can put everybody else on Overwatch, so they'll be running into Overwatch with holo-targeting active. I've never actually done it before. Might be worth trying. We actually try Get Some. I want to see if Get Some applies to units above him as well, or whether it's just going to apply to the person next to him. These are all mechanical questions that I really haven't thought about yet. We have 2 frost bombs, so I don't see any reason why not freeze this pod, kill it outright, and then be ready for the reaction. So I think going to give us the best chance to leave Campana in stealth. Let's see. Governator, you don't actually need to be up there. Because he's just gonna suppress. I want. Chris is our biggest source of damage. He's gonna be shooting twice at that pod.
Yeah,
I want the heart advantage. Good stepping there, buddy. Yeah, I'm happy to move our shotgunners here. Oh, look at that. 3 explosive grenades. Beautiful. 3 frags. Weapon range isn't affecting us that much.
Heading out.
Yeah, 1 or 2 more turns. These guys are gonna move, but 1 or 2 more turns and we can go.
On Overwatch.
Another reason to use the freeze grenade is it can also justify using trench guns. I can hit all 3 with a shotgun. What are my heck chances? Shutdown 94, sweet. Control enemy is not good. That's also a good shutdown. By no means guaranteed.
Got a guard. Affirmative, covering now.
Oh, we got a lot of aliens. And the fact that they've come towards us doesn't really help either. They are super, super close. I kind of want to try the holo-target everybody, Overwatch everyone else tactic. But I'm concerned it's too dangerous, because look at all the hit points we have here. That's 8, that's 30, that's 21 hit points there, that's plus 9, that's 30 hit points together. I'm not confident we can do that all in just interaction shots. And of course you want Chris to shoot twice. Particularly as, look at his crit chance, 58, look at aggression giving him 15% hit chance there. Plus 4 crit damage, he's going to hit super hard. Did our sniper see anything? No. Disappointed, I thought that would have been...
Get me into position!
in hardcover. On the next target, the next turn rather, we'll have the sniper open up. Crit chance will be plus, you have 70-odd% crit chance.
This is boring.
Overwatch.
Governor, can you safely get down there? No, but you don't even need to be honest.
Okay.
Okay. That beautiful accent. Good, because he can do what he has to do from there. Right, we're gonna go live next turn.
Roger, I've got my eyes on. On Overwatch.
It sounds awesome. We'll be super lucky they'll even stand next to one of these explosive vehicles. Ooh, that's close, it's literally right underneath the compartment. That's crazy. This guy jumps over. Oh, there goes the spot. I don't quite know how that counted as a reveal. It was behind cover, but good damage. Oh! So, not ideal, but it looks like we're gonna wipe them just on the Overwatch. What? Impana and half cover gonna get shot at. Ooh, that's a lot of snakes. Sidewinder, what are you shooting with? Oh, that's so cool. It's using a plasma SMG. Okay, so that's 7 so far. 8 if we count the turret. What the hell?
We have visual.
What the hell was that? Was that mech doing? There's 2 more. That's 10. For a second there, I thought that mech was launching grenades at us. Oh, we're through smoke. Interesting. 2 more. That's 12 aliens. 13 including the turret. My god, that's a lot of aliens. I'm so glad they weren't grenading us. Okay, so we've still got problems though. Let's see. What I want to do is take control of this heavy turret at some point, but let's just for now find all the good high cover spots. We're going to need someone there with a shotgun, but do we have a visual on that snake? We do. Look at that, 100%. Precision 33, this is definitely worth taking. Unlikely crit, but it does 6 decent points of damage. So, take one shot and then Overwatch, Chris. Or do we not Overwatch? Do we maybe... No, we do Overwatch, definitely. Aussie Lass. Governator. I don't want the Governator over there. I can't see him getting there. Turn. Can anybody get to that spot? No, not quite. Not quite. That's high cover there, so I'm happy to put James there.
Affirmative.
Gotta be super careful with everybody here. I'm worried with putting... Okay, good. That's a solid pillar. I was worried to put the Governor there in case it was just not a solid wall.
You're behind, and you're on your own.
But the point is, if he gets grenaded here... Ooh. That's tempting. That's also super tempting. Only 48 aim. I don't wanna... I kinda wanna put Yossi Less up nice and close. Well, clearly that's always what we have to do here. We have to heal.
Healer mode.
Be very careful with Kempona. He's only got 6 hit points, so he's not that tough. James can get there.
Heading out.
Just want to make sure I can use the Aussie Lass at exactly the right time. shooting, buddy.
It's
one down, 12 left. If I had known that Oni can get to this guy. Sidewinder, I mean. What if I shouldn't pull Oni back? Why are you showing us flanked, Campana? Alright. Pull Campana back. Because he's facing half cover. Ooh, I was gonna hunker him down, but alright, never mind.
Scouting.
Yeah, I don't want Oni to be in vision, so I'd rather pull him back. I encourage his aliens to come to us and take the Overwatch. Where do we want the Aussie lass? I want her flanking from this side here. On that basis, I'm gonna run her all the way back here.
Double time.
So we gotta wait for these snakes to come to us now and pull them into our Overwatch. I'm just hanging on to the aid protocol now because I know the snakes can use that tongue bullshit. On, where's the Overwatch? Don't poison. Oh my god. What is it with this campaign and full cover? We get hit through full cover so much. It's ridiculous. That's like the fourth or fifth shot being taken at us in where we're in high cover and it just hits us every time. It's unbelievable. It seems statistically improbable, but hey, that's XCOM. Yes, Sidewinder, you're on Overwatch. Snakey Snake, what are your percentages? Chris, can you see these two? You can, so why the hell didn't you overwatch that prick?
Oh, your brains are running away from you!
I want him to grab this reload.
Lock and load!
Viper Serpens, god that's cool. 26. 90 is pretty damn good. Take it and keep pulling back, I think. Dodge, you bastard.
Put it down for good.
I could grenade and then run the Aussie lass up here. Yeah, particularly as I can take a fairly safe route to get there. Boom, because from there she can run and gun and shoot it, but then we need to blow up that cover. Can do that.
On the move.
Don't catch on fire, James. Man.
Frag out.
Don't tell me if cover is still there. And also, I would point out that we're 6 days away from getting Predator armor, and thank God for that. Won't come a moment too soon. Running out of med packs quickly, only two left. I need to remember to hang on to one so that we can use it to stabilize anybody that goes down. Now, what did we work out the last time? It was there, no, it was one above.
On the move.
That shouldn't trigger Overwatch. If it does, we've got the aid protocol. Okay, good job. Be fairly accurate as well. This trench gun not roll for accuracy, okay, but it can't go through the cover, which is fair enough to be honest. I wonder if we can get Oni there to have vision from high cover, probably. Oh yeah, with height advantage as well.
I'll be back.
Yeah. I'm not gonna suppress it, I'm gonna take the shot actually, because with the height it should be a fairly accurate shot. It's into half cover. Misses of course,
holy
but at least
shit.
But at least it applies. There you go, 94% now. If you dodge again, you piece of shit snake, I swear to god. On one hit point. Oh god, wait, is that not showing us? Why is he showing us flanked? That was, yeah, it is full cover. Why is he being showing us flanked? I'm gonna do a quick save and reload just to see if that's not a bug, because I have had this bug before where even though it shows you in cover, it shows you as flanked, and then when the enemy shoots, it's 100% to hit because it's not counting it as cover. So, give me a sec, I'm gonna save and be back in a sec. Reload, I mean. And we're back, and the save and reload had the intended effect, fixing Arnie's showing his flank thing. I think that's an interaction with, there's actually a mod called High Cover for these turret spots. Working on that one now, but anyway, good. So Arnie should be showing his high cover now, as indeed he should have in the first place.
Yes.
Ben, can you see that snake? 84% you can. Well, I wonder if we can't get someone with a shotgun to finish it off. No, it's only Ben and Campana. The Tiberius, take him down. Good hit. Still got one other snake out there though. Worries me. I would move Campana here, but I don't want to group him up with Ben, because that's just asking to be Viper poisoned. This shouldn't take Overwatch from the turret. Okay, it doesn't. So yeah, if we have the supplies, we'll be able to get Predator armor in 5 days. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 more aliens to come at us. The beauty is we're not under any time pressure, so we'll just let them come to us. Okay. You see that little puke from there? Can't.
Here I come.
Maybe you can see something else. Hello! That's a lot of lids. Now they're all gonna take CCS. God damn, look at that natural defense. So instead I wanna pull them to where they will take Overwatch. 16, wow, they're still gonna be, well, they're still gonna be in range of the Aussie lads, probably. But at least if they have to come to here, they will be going into Overwatch. Chris? Gotta be super careful with this fire now, that's spreading quite a lot. Yeah, we know he's gonna react if he goes about there, so I'm happy with where he is. Arnie? Now they take the shot to get rid of that. Yeah, the choice is between just shooting once for the damage or area suppressing to holo target all of them. But I think they won't count as holo targeted when they are on the next turn, so not worth it, I don't think. Could frag? Nah. What can you do, Sean? Yeah, take the shot, why not? No reason not to. Get rid of that bloody shield. And see if we can finish it off. Yeah, Oni.
The greatest feeling you can get is the pump.
The pump. To be fair, the pump is the greatest feeling. Rams, are you in danger of catching on fire here, buddy boy? No, so just... I want to say... Take that high cover there with a shotgun? Yeah, that's fine.
I'm on it.
I mean, he's already been injured this mission, so he may as well. Whoa, have I overreached now? Potentially. These two are going to be running into Overwatch. So what we need is... potentially quite dangerous now. 38, 51. Frag grenade for guaranteed damage, maybe? And we have so many... We have so many grenades. I think I'm going to wait for the Overwatch there. Findable Overwatch as well. I'm aware that a lot of these Overwatches are very unlikely to hit. Because you are taking reaction shots at range with shotguns against lids that have pretty hard defense. But I don't want to compromise my position. I think it's the right thing to do to stay where we are. Also, President Alice, 8 hit points. We can always heal him up.
Got it covered.
I can live to regret this decision now. Shot from downtown. But the snake is going to be messing up our Overwatch here on those chrysalids. Oh, there's something else there. Now come the shots that need to hit. Bad miss. Yeah, I think we're going to take at least one chrysalid punch. Misses everywhere, just misses.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
Well, that's gonna hit.
Seriously?
Ooh, six damage, good god. Yay! Fuzzy lass. That's what I was hoping for. Well, a grenadier jaw is gonna be out for ages. I can see this bloody thing, so let's go ahead. Look at that wonderful damage. That's the beauty of this center mass ability. I think it is now time to start moving back though. Cheetah has lightning reflexes, so that's fine. If I knew what was there, I could actually put her here and depend on her CCS ability, but no. I think it's the mech, actually.
Let's
so on that basis, already. I'll just move her back. Overwatch. Reload. Overwatch.
I understand.
And we'll use our last heal on James.
Gremlin medical detail.
Whatever is there, I need to make sure we can't get flanked by it. I'm actually pretty concerned that we might do. Yeah, I think what was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so these two positions are compromised as far as I'm concerned. Let's put these boys. Yeah. Is that going to be safe? Yes. I think this will be because, you know, there's a turret and a turret. But whatever else was there, I'm confident enough that's not going to come through here and take a shot at James. Though, 7 hit points. I'm not quite so sure now. I think, yeah, let's just compromise. Bring him back here. Jack, stay where you are.
On the move.
Yeah, Frozen Isle's gonna be out forever. He took
moving to Overwatch.
Two separate hits. He's in a lot of pain. Woody, reload, bro. Now Tiberius is interesting. I think we can't keep him here, but I think that there should be just fine. I like that we haven't had to use the frost bombs and whatnot just yet. We're a little grouped up. I'm a touch concerned that we might have a mech. Oh, good hit. But it dodges though, the bastard thing.
Fairly registered.
Yeah, that's what I was worried about. It is the mech indeed. Oh, great hit. Any chance we can finish it off? Come on, Arnie, you legend. Ooh, Beastmaster. Ooh, took his cover out though. How about he's pushing forward some more? Yes, Jack. Now our team's performing the way they should. Cool, now we should just need to finish up here, and we're done.
No guts, no gore.
Dory.
Okay.
Want to move him away from that fire. That concerns me. Enman. She can actually flashay this now because the first lightning reflexes will keep her safe.
Enemy firing this side.
0%. There you go. And that, friends, is why you take lightning reflexes. Still 0% as well. Get slain, snake.
How many is that now?
Oh, there's more. Okay, well hell, we can even start pushing forward.
No problemo.
I mean, it's not going to expect us to kill the turrets, certainly not. So there must be one.
To be or not to be. Not to be.
Arnie, you're just so quotable, my friend. What a ledge.
Back online, Overwatch!
Campana. Where'd I put you, bro? I'm really enjoying the Shinobi class, which surprises me. When I looked at the abilities, I didn't think it would be that good, but being able to, you know, increase all the melee attacks and being able to sneak around has just been invaluable. Okay, what do we have? Probably another snake, maybe? Oh, something else.
They're all over me.
Let's see. That'll be a shield bearer plus something else. Gotta stop being careful now. We're in danger of running into overwatch shots from those towers. But again, there's no reason whatsoever to rush.
Okay.
And I'm gonna pull Henman back and towards the rest of the squad. But once she can get a visual on that turret, we can just shoot it with a sniper.
This is boring.
He's not gonna do anything.
Finally.
The sniper actually. But as long as Inman just absorbs the overwatch like that, we're fine.
Okay.
Okay. Careful, whoopsie, that must click.
I guess that will be okay. On overwatch.
Come on. There you go.
Heading out.
He's got a negative state. What is that? Penalties, red fog. Okay, yeah, fair enough.
Standing fast.
So we can move Shawn Ward a little closer, but of course keep an eye on those fires. This is going to keep burning away portions of the roof here. Ooh, you're actually in visual range. Interesting. Oh, that's alright. With a hunker down, you'll be just fine, I think. Hello, buddy. 13%, no problem. At least we can use the grenades now, so that's not a problem. Oh, come on! 29% and hits. Yeah, that was more accurate than I thought it would be. I want to run and gun Henman here and grenade that turret. This is gonna let us really close. Actually, Henman can throw a grenade at the turret because Jawara will be able to launch a grenade at that shield bearer at the back. I don't expect it to make the turret fall down and destroy it, but just a shred a bit of the armor. Which is fine. If we're lucky, it'll fall down and just... Oh! Yep, there you go. Destroyed turret. Can't argue with that. Get your aura.
Moving to position.
Grenade that target, please. This should shred his turret, his cover, because he's standing behind, you know, where the ladder is. If he was behind that structure, we wouldn't be able to destroy that pillar. But that straight wall will should be destroyed. There you go. Yeah, tricked. Now we can just move forward, even into half cover, and just take pot shots at this guy. Can't see him. Who can see him? Sniper, maybe? No. Ben, can you get to a spot where you can see this guy? Can, but not from any cover. Oh, wait, hang on. That's vision. Nice. Can Arnie get into a spot where you can see him? Yes. Want that holo targeting. Right, Governator, let him have it. And another...
As a fucking asshole.
Yes, you are. Ben. Good hit. Stun maybe? Nope. Only 20% is very unlikely. Oh, why can't you get close enough now? even though we can't see him with the rest of our troops, it's just worth putting our troopers into Overwatch. Oh, that's a hit.
All right.
Yeah, buddy. Another miss. Seriously, how many 80% shots are gonna miss with that hair trigger? Fire a pistol for 2 to 3. Ah, oh, cause it's the Shadow Keeper. Bloody hell. Oh well, take your free reload.
Cock locked and ready to roll.
I'm trusting you here.
So half cover's kinda risky. You can do 5 to 6 damage. But only 53 aim. Yeah, I'm confident he won't double hit you, Jack. Yeah, it's time to move Wardy all the way there. He should have better vision now on the next turn. There's still one more of these pigs messing around as well. Oh, how can that not have triggered an Overwatch? Come on. What the fuck? What was the percentage there? Seriously. It must have been a super low to hit percentage. It's pissing me off. The 53% shooting into half cover, that's another 30% shot that's hit. Well, at least we left one charge for stabilize. Pisses me off, man. God damn it. Unconscious, but he is stabilized. Alright, you are gonna pay for that, motherfucker. In the face!
What are those?
Here I come!
Righty, so we've got one alien up there. Hair trigger, iron skin. Melee damage by 3, interesting. Peter will sell that.
I've got the loot.
Okay. Ooh, a muton. Wow, he's a big boy too. Can we get a grenade and some follow-up shots onto him? Probably not. His move will be to take that spot there. What is our move? Can we just blow his shit up? Probably can. I have a grenade angle from there, but we should do from here.
On your order.
I know it's half cover, but I'm confident we can kill him this turn. Oh, he's behind a pillar. We have an ice grenade going. Probably on the other grenadier. Oh, wait a second. Where are the ice grenades? We did bring ice grenades, didn't we? Oh, they're on Ben Barton, obviously. The guy's been downed. Typical.
Throwing grenade!
Now, I don't expect this to... take its cover away, but it'll be good damage, but armor shred. Make him think about moving. Well, it did remove his cover. Awesome. Arnie, can you get a visual from anywhere? Any of these blue spots, can you get a visual? I think maybe we need to blow open this cover a bit more. Another grenade might do it. That should be vision, surely. If we go up there and open that door, we should have vision. No, we won't. Fuck. We can flashbang him. If Cassie doesn't die this turn. Really annoyed that we can't get a visual on this bloody thing. Any of these spots? Come on, seriously. Run up there and grenade. Really want to get Arnie's, can take that away and hit him again, that'll be good. Come on, Chris, you had it. Both of those. Oh, being too greedy here? Probably. Doesn't matter that I didn't hit him. We just want to get a visual. There we go. Hold on, he gets some revenge for Ben. Although Ben is still alive, thank goodness. Only 3 damage.
All day long.
Not a lot of damage, man. Good shot, Campano. 14 damage, awesome.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Good.
Status confirmed.
3 wounds, god. Yeah, I'm being careless, but hell, at least the roster is fairly robust. Yeah, it's forcing us to rotate our soldiers. That's my excuse. I'm purposefully letting our guys get injured so I can rotate them. It's Crimson Tome. Okay, mission. Yeah, common soldiers, not particularly good. Not our finest performance. You know, I got overconfident there at the end. So, one of you guys in a way earlier video made the comment that you wish there was greater variety in the enemies. Well, you got them. We saw, I think, 3 different types of snakes there. And the Advent Troopers are quite different as well now. The guy was a Beastmaster, whatever they do. Jewel bearers are still dickheads though, super annoying. Everybody out for like 2 weeks probably. At least we have the AWC to heal them quicker, so. All of this might mean nothing at all if we don't get the proving ground built, of course. Only 8 days. 17 days, not too bad. Interesting choice here. Enemy attacks suffer 50 penalty to critical hits. Fire the pistol 3 times at the same target. Grazing fire. Missed shots with your primary weapon have an additional roll to become a graze. I kind of like that because it means we can take the stock off of the rifle. I mean, it's a chance to become a graze, not guaranteed graze damage. But I don't like fan fire. What's gunslinger? Take a reaction shot with your pistol against any enemy that moves or attacks in 8 tiles. No, bring them on. We'll be taking bring them on, that's for damn sure. Damage on critical hits for each enemy you can see, together with aggression, center mass, and lethal is going to make for some gigantic damage. Attack sense, no. Lethal, and then rapid reaction, I think. That's a hybrid. Lots of damage. If shooting twice. Plus good. And that's each shot you hit grants another action fire, so that's a maximum of 3 shots, so it's essentially maximum of 3 overwatch shots every time he overwatches, because he'll be so accurate but he's not going to miss. So I think grazing fire will we go with here. The Governator locked on because we'll be taking chain shot next. Frozen Owl, Flashbanger, Enter Mass. Just flashbanger, I just want loads of grenades. Loads of nades. We'll take probably dense smoke at the next one. Sting grenades, hell yeah, your flashbang grenades have a chance to stun enemies, that's awesome. Rapid deployment. So the throw will not cost an action. Salvo is quite a good one. Launching or throwing grenades will not end your turn, so you can grenade and then shoot. Or grenade and grenade again, which is awesome. Full kit, 1 charge per grenade item in a utility slot. This is plus 1 grenade. Volatile mix. Your grenade's area of effect is increased by 1 tile. Probably go for full kit. The 2 grenades, because you're going to have 3 slots, so yeah. Let's just check whether he has grenade, utility, grenade, or grenade, utility, utility. 10 days, that's not too bad. Someone here is going to suffer reduced will, I'm sure. No, awesome. You soldiers, grenadier, loadout. That's utility and grenade. But we'll see once he has Predator armor whether it's a second utility or a second grenade slot. Okay. Oh, that's interesting. For 26 days, we have the supplies but not the power. Get building on the proving ground. Ooh. You have the power.
Facility construction.
Awesome.
Initiated.
So how long is that going to take? 14 days? Well, we still need to go back to base and spin for rapid construction, I think. There's just no time to lose. 14 days is going to leave us with 12 days. 8 days to get the Skulljack. 4 days.
Setting course for Mexico.
If that was end of the month supplies, I'd go for that, but it's not. That doesn't expire, so we can get that whenever. So what does that do to Proving Ground? Look, it's taken 5 days off the Proving Ground. They're well worth doing. Awesome. Nice supplies. And alloys, which we definitely need. Just get the power coil going, I wonder. Yes. Then as soon as we can, we'll get this power coil up and running. Which means we can then destroy this power relay, because we need that space or something else. I'm quite sure what. Maybe it'll be the research and an item, well, some sort of structure that's not going to need a gremlin. We're going to put a workshop here, leave one gremlin. We get four gremlins, which will give us like the Avenger. Four gremlins, two of which will go into the comms facility. It'll be comms facility, comms facility. Alright. Good. Good, good, good. Doing it, folks. Doing it. Let's take a look at our... What specialists do we have available? I think just two of them. Just Jack. And Kittybot. Because I died. So I want to take both of them out. I want to get Tanya up to... sergeant, so I can give her the training as well. Can we put back in there? Defilade. Soldiers within command range of the leader receive +5 bonus to defensive value. Okay, focus fire. Spend an action point to target and grant your squad cumulative aim bonuses and one armor piercing on attacks against the target for the rest of the turn. Is Defilade a passive skill? Soldiers within command range receive +5 bonus to defense value. It's only +5 and it forces us to group up, which I don't like. Action point to pinpoint a target and grant your squad cumulative aim bonuses and one armor piercing on attacks against that target. Okay, so it's like basically the skill that says you see that guy, fuck that guy. Which is great for high armor targets, so the armor piercing and aim. And what are they called again? Big stompy robot
still
things.
Hard at work on the current research priority, Commander. The aliens have considerable resources.
Just keep spinning until the proving ground's done. I think we have another recruit who needs to go for training. Rookies, where are the rookies? We've got two left. Flores and Hansen. Oh, yes, they were going to be either Rangers or Shinobis. The specialists, we have three. One of them needs to be a sharpshooter, but can't justify with those shit stats. We'll have to recruit someone else with higher accuracy. The two assaults, two shinobi. So one will be an assault, one will be a shinobi. Make Flores an assault, I think. Yes, rookie training. Assault. Nice. Yeah, we have Flores doing some burpees probably. Who's there doing crunches? Looks like Ben. Not loving. Oh, he's hating the crunches. That sucks. Nice push up form. Look at that. Knock him out. We need the governor to here. Come with me if you want to lift. money left to work out.
What can I do for you, Commander?
Back. Okay, no engineers available. Can we build any items? Probably some weapons, but they're not really needed right now. And we're going to hang on to these supplies to get the Skulljack just as soon as we can.
You lived in one of the colonies for a few years before linking up the Central, right?
Yes, one of the advantages of working with Advent. On the surface, it was very comfortable, but there was a price for that comfort.
The millions of people in those cities don't seem to mind all that much.
Yes, but Advent is always watching. Between their forces and the aliens themselves, they see everything, not to mention the automated systems. There's nothing quite like providing identification to...
Sorry, Target, I'm sure that was fascinating, but you just waffle on so much, we can't pay attention to you, mate. Plated armor, oh yeah.
This outcome, though it is intriguing.
Fantastic. We will build that as soon as we know how much it costs and how much money. Oh, sweet, instant vapor autopsy.
Although I would expect to be growing more accustomed to seeing the clear intermingling of both human and alien genetic material, I must admit, this reptilian creature with such distinctive human features is surprisingly unsettling. Invasion-era reports include references to a species with some reptilian qualities, but nothing as readily apparent as this.
So I think what he's alluding to is them big old snake boobies.
I find it unusual, to say the least, that the subject so often referred to in the past as the Thin Man has now been revealed to actually be a genetic derivative of this wholly reptilian creature.
Why would a snake need boobies? They don't need memory glands. Oh, XCOM, you weird. The turret breakdown, no. Psionics, no. Gauss weapons, that's the one I think we want. We're not going to do the faceless autopsy. Oh, hang on, that's super tempting. Let's just get the Stun Lancer autopsy so we can get those improved swords.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units.
I want these improved swords because I went and lost the bloody axe, didn't I, a few episodes ago. Okay, proving ground in 5 days. We should be good. The proving ground, first thing we'll do is Skulljack and then blue screen rounds, I think. Alrighty, so dark event, we'll probably pay for that. Let's see what it is. Engineer, poison rounds, that kind of sucks, but I don't mind that too much. Immune to fire, that's, we don't need to do this one because we don't particularly, well, we need the sharpshooter and a sergeant would be great, but we aren't using immune to fire, poison, and we aren't using those type of rounds anyway, so. Can I pay the cost to see what that hidden event is? Don't have, oh, we do have the intel, let's see what it is. The less time to complete concealed missions, you see? That is why you reveal. God, destroy the relay, another difficult one. Can we afford to get predator armor? I don't think so.
Hello, Commander.
300 supplies, good God. Yeah, that's expensive. We'll certainly do it, though, as soon as we can afford it. Just as soon as the proving ground is done and we've built the Skulljack, then the next 300 supplies, which we have over here waiting for us, just can't afford to go get them. 6 supplies in 22 hours. Okay, yeah, we have to go do that. Okay, so this should be the last mission where we don't have predator armor. Okay, destroy the alien relay.
Setting course.
We'll be taking our sniper along on that for damn sure. Destroying relay missions, you need snipers. Sit at the back and snipe. Okay, Warder, you can stay there. Give us a shinobi. We didn't actually finish that Thunder Lancer autopsy, did we? No, so just take an auto shotgun. Regular sword, nothing else for you to do, really. I want to say flashbang, but no, frag grenade is... Flashbang. We'll take both our specialists along, because we're going to need Jack. No, Jack's in training there. You want to take him out of training? What is the difficulty rating here? Difficult, yeah, we should. Oh, I can't pull him out. Oof. Okay then, Kitty Bot Selena. You are on healing detail. 67 aim is rubbish. So we'll give you the bolt caster. Gremlin Mark 2, yeah, that's fine. Only 3 health, good god. That is just atrocious. Melee damage, it's not gonna take melee damage. Give her an extra bit of will. Will is super low. Well, we've got to give her something just to increase her will. Okay, that's, we are gonna have to be so super careful with her on this mission. I mean, I would give her an armor, a piece of armor, but oh god. Even that'll only give up to 4 health. I only have 3 health, what the hell? Well, 9 dodge at least, so. Okay. Gotta take care of Kitty. And definitely take out a second medkit. Okay, she goes down and survives. That's on you, Mr. Sniper Pants. Okay, let's take Donkey Rod out. Let's take a tier 2 assault, I want to say. Exile Davies. Only again, 3 hit points. That's no good. Okay. We obviously can't use him until... okay, no, never mind. We have a specialist with 4 hit points, so we'll take him instead of Kitty. Kitty Bot won't come out until we have Predator Armor. I think taking out here is just far too risky. As great as a pink armor does look. Where is he? Hoon. And with 73 base aim, he's not too bad either. Interesting outfit, we have to change that up. I don't like that outfit, buddy. Still only one medkit though, so we have to watch out for that. Donkey Rod the Ranger. Take the... Where's the Bumblebee? No. Weapons available, please. That's not worked. For sake. Chris, give up the damn bumblebee, man. There you go. 86 will... Let's give him the battle scan out. He's not really going to be throwing a grenade, and I want that ability to battle scan. It's super important. To make sure these two at the back good. For them to lose their items. A auto shotgun, a regular sword, a frag grenade. Is there anything we can throw at that shotgun? Hair trigger, definitely. But we should probably just leave that as a regular mag shotgun, given the problems we might have with using the custom shotgun. Okay. So, not the TNT, this will be the hairy shotty. Weapon color is fine, pattern is fine. Anything we can put onto the sword? No, repeaters don't go on swords, don't be stupid. Nothing on the Kevlar armor. Hey, what are we missing here? Grenadier. Bot Fox, welcome. Ben Barton available already. He went down in the last mission and he's available. Interesting. Let's take two gunners. Well, actually, not just yet. We'll take the one gunner. I would take out a second gunner if we were able to use the mag tier weapons, but we obviously can't. But Fox, what's your aim? 65, still crap, so a shotgun is fine. Bolt caster, rather. 2 frost bombs. And another grenadier, I think. Or loads of explosives, but Barton also has pretty shit aim. Eh, shotgun's just fine. Okay, friends, so here's your squad for Operation Moon Tower. We're gonna destroy an alien relay. We got Captain Wardy, Scorcher, Yoon, Donkey Rod, Ozzyless, Quad Fox, the Governator, and Tiberius. As always, thanks very much for watching. This is XCOM 2, and I'll see you next time.